ओके गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम पार्ट अबाउट वेब सर्विसेस एंड वेब एपीआई. ओके व्हाट आर दिस टू थिंग्स, व्हाट आर डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू एंड विच इज द इन विच कॉन्टेक्स्ट वी हैव टू यूज विच. ओके दैट वी आर गोइंग टू चेक टुडे. And today, yesterday might be we have not fully completed the sample example of web API. Okay, so I will try to give one simple example for that one also. It's a live, yesterday also we have discussed it's a live only. So we'll quickly move for that one, how we can use that one. And just within few minutes, we'll switch to theoretical part, okay. So in this one already my server is running today. Okay, this is yesterday we have created the application in this one com. Okay, this is a getter setter class, means it will get only properties. These properties we will use for marshalling the information. Marshalling is nothing but the information what we receive right from the provider, we convert that into an object. As we have converted XML to object, right, the same way the process of converting information like string or anything to an object and object to a string, we can say marshalling and unmarshalling. So we should have to use a getter setter class. Okay, in this one we have some variables. Okay, we have already seen this one. So this is a weather servlet is there. So in this one first we are getting the requested city, which requested city from the JSP we are getting. Okay I will show you that one. Okay, after getting that in city, we are using this HTTP client, and using the HTTP client jar file we are requesting to the one API that is provided by provider is Open Weather, right. After requesting that API by using some city name, we are dynamically passing the city name, and this is my app key, means which is provided by the Open Weather map. Okay, after requesting to this one, this okay provider will send some information based on my request to me, and after that request I will convert to a string format, and again simultaneously I will convert to that JSON, the string I receive in a JSON format. JSON format is nothing but it is similar to XML, which is used to use for information exchange between servers, okay, between two endpoints. Okay, but it is easier than JSON is easier than XML. Okay, so because of that reason most of the today's trend is JSON. Earlier it was XML. We now companies are using XML as well as JSON, but most of the times JSON we are going to use. Okay, and we are just printing that one, and after that one we are setting that information for the JSON file, for the JSP file. Okay, how we are setting? First we'll check whether our received information is not null, then we are putting into the session. You can check out as we are making one weather object setting attribute, and we are putting the information, and we are redirecting to the display weather. In the display weather, okay, these are nothing but CSS and jQuery files I'm using. You guys have to go through later this one, this is not important today. You can check out in this one cell drop down box is there, select, and one button is there, right, button check weather. Whenever this after selecting this must city, if we click on this button, it will go to this servlet. Okay, after it will retrieve the city, which city we have requested, perform all the activities, and again it will redirect to the same page itself. In the same page we are going to display the other information of the city. Okay, so we'll try to run this one. Okay, give me a minute, I'm just trying to run this one. Yeah, here is there already I'm running my in my local server, I have already started. You guys can check out now. you guys can check out. It is initially it is showing me Bangalore, anything Chennai, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Kolkata, Chennai. And in this one we'll select first Kolar and we'll click. Okay, if I click this one in my local server, okay, in my local I have created a calm weather, right? You can check out that calm weather. I'm calling from here, weather calm. That class servlet I am calling, and in this servlet I am going to communicate with the provider HTTP using HTTP. Okay, when I click, it is calling to the com servlet. You can check out, it is giving a temperature, it is in Celsius format 33. Okay, when I tested, okay, afternoon at 12:30 something, it was showing 31 point. Now maximum temperature, it is reaching to the maximum temperature. Okay, minimum temperature also it is same only. And pressure, what is the pressure in the air, okay, what is humidity in the air. But description, there is no such description, cloudy or non cloudy, it's not like that. Okay, it description is not provided. If we'll check for London, what is the London weather now? Okay, it's 12 Celsius, that's it. Okay, it is, thank God it is 12 now. When I tested morning, right, it was 7. I don't know how the peoples are living. So we will check out quickly the London weather, what is current now. Okay, you can check out 13. This is almost approximate 12.89. it is almost approximate. So it is just ceiling, means it is incrementing and showing that one as a 13. You can check out our what we are getting information from the web services, means API, that is almost, means it is accurate information only we are getting, and pressure, humidity and everything. If we are going to check Bangalore, we will check. Yeah, you can check out in Bangalore some different weather is there. Okay, this way we can utilize, you can check out humidity is very high. This way we can communicate between lots of different servers using one application only. Whether we don't want to know the architecture of the provider, whatever they are using, we doesn't care. Only what we want this link which they are providing, and we want the access point, means they should be registered us for accessing point. That's it, we want that's it, so we can easily work. So in this one, what I'm using HTTP client, right? This is one thing I'm using, and another one thing is JSON I'm using. What JSON, what it is used, it will convert the information, this way information, to my object. Object is nothing but this P is my class. Okay, you can check out, this is my weather class. Weather class is nothing but this only. So all the information what it will receive as a string format, it will push the all information to the variables, and it will give me the object. So using that object, I can use this in the JSP. You can check out the same weather, say from the session I'm getting that same object, and I'm just doing all the access point, accessing the information. This is a simple way of using one API. Okay, please try to understand what is the use of API. So we will quickly move for our session. Today also I have shared that point also. And another one thing I forgot to tell you, how I'm using some extra points, right? Okay, you can check out in library some files I have added. Okay, some files HTTP, these are the jar files. Okay, if we come to here point, I'm using this HTTP like client and this functionality, right? Those all functionality comes in these two jar files. This jar files provide this functionality and JSON functionality, right? This conversion of a string to my one object, that is given by this JSON jar file. So all the classes interfaces reside in this one. So if I want to use JSON, I should have to import this one. Okay, and some other common logging files. Okay, these are for handling some Tomcat server activity. Okay, some documenting and all the things. So these are the three libraries we should have to import while we are communicating using this jar files. Okay, this is one thing we have quickly done. So we'll move. Okay, we'll move further in theoretical part now. Shall we move? Okay, I believe that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. We'll move, okay? Now we will check out some theoretical part in this. Okay. Now, what is a web service? We have already discussed that one. This is a web service. We are going to communicate with different platform. Okay, different servers like this. We are going to do. And what is the aim? To exchange of information. Example, using .NET application, I cannot access Java resources. Okay, some Java resources are there, servers are there. Okay, I need to communicate with them. I don't want to know architecture, anything. I don't want to know about the Java application or any person who is providing the services. So using the web API, the Java provider will create some web services that .NET consumer will use. Okay, so you can check out a cloud also here. So might you are also knowing about the cloud computing. Cloud computing is nothing but the web services only. Means the provider will provide a lots of web services. Okay, those web services reside at one server and any number of client can access the web services. Okay, there will be some conceptual limitation will be there, boundaries will be there for differentiate each and every user, but those everything cloud computing is going to be implement using the web services only. Okay, this is remember the things. So web service is a technology to communicate one programming language with another, for example Java programming language, or interact with PHP, .NET, or using a web service in other web service provider way of interoperability. Okay, this is interoperability, means without knowing other architecture we can communicate with them. Okay, how we communicate with them? We can exchange the information, we can send the information to them, otherwise we can receive the information from them. Okay, now if we come to Amazon web services, okay, example Amazon AWS Lambda, Amazon Kinesis, other web services, Amazon web services E2C, okay, e-commerce too, okay, Amazon DynamoDB, public accessibility, whatever they have written, right, they have written in a web services and API gateway only. Okay, they have created all the gateway and everything, and this gateway they are providing to their clients. Okay, we have to register as a Amazon client, we have to request them that this services we want to access. So using that one we can create our own web application, and as I have, okay, today we have access a weather, right, the same way we can access the Amazon web services. There is no difference, only the same point will, same programming will be there. We can use the web services of the Amazon in using somewhat mobile application, web application, IoT devices, or any other private devices also we can use. So we'll check what is the features of this SOAP or API. Okay, it is XML based and JSON based. So what is the feature of XML is that one, in any language we have a capability to process the XML. Okay, it's very simple, self-descriptive, that we have in last session only we have discussed the features and everything, right? And it is doesn't have clear, it will make a clear separation between presentation as well as the data. Loosely coupled, yeah, this is the best reason we go for SOAP and API. Example, here the web Amazon is providing web services, and here is the architecture, database, and some other resources, processor and everything. So here our web application is there, right? So if Amazon do any changes to here, or web application features, if we change some additional functionality, it is changed, it doesn't affect to our application. If we request to that resources, it will be processed, it will be given a information to us, that's it. Okay, so whatever the different web services are there, they are loosely coupled. If we change any one also, it doesn't affect to others. Coerce again means the whatever the functionality we have already, Java object oriented or C hash, that also object oriented, or any other like Python. Okay, these all are having the functionality of web services. We can create and we can use the features of Java, and we can create the web services. Ability to be synchronous and asynchronous. Yes, we have already discussed about thread, right? Thread will continue, means whenever we create multiple thread, they will simultaneously execute together. That is called asynchronous. Okay, means they are running continuously together. Okay, synchronize nothing but that also we have seen in the thread. That one synchronization can be happen, means while executing some process, okay, it will wait for other process to be complete. Okay, the same way the web services also provide the features. That one we can make a web service as a synchronized or asynchronous. Okay, what today I have used, right, web services, that is synchronous. It will completely make a request and it will wait for the response. Once it will get the response, it will give me the response result. Okay, support remote procedure call. This is the actually main definition of this one. Remote procedures call, we don't know where is that open weather is there, where it is locating, whether it is locating in London, America, in China, we don't know, but we are able to access that one. Means remotely we can call the procedures, right? Support document exchange, not only information like XML or something. Within the XML we can exchange PDF also, we can exchange video also, we can exchange audio also. We can receive a video, we can receive a audio also. Example, what is the best example for this one is Bluetooth. Bluetooth provide lots of services, right? We know if I am registered to Bluetooth, Bluetooth is already given that access to me, and whenever I will register one delivery, okay, what is delivery is nothing but I am ordering the Bluetooth to pick some material some one place and deliver to another place, then at that time the Bluetooth will give me the invoices in a PDF format, and that PDF is included in the XML or JSON. Okay, now we'll check some information about web services. A web service can be defined in the following ways. It is a client server application or a application component for communication, the method of communication between two devices over a network. Okay, the method of communication between two devices over a network. This also we have seen today one example. It is a software system for interoperable machine to a machine. This also the same meaning, means a machine. This is my laptop from which I am presenting to you guys, and open weather map is another machine, but over a internet we are able to communicate. It is a collection of standards or protocol for exchanging information between two devices or application. Yeah, what are the different types of services? Mainly there are two types of services. One is SOAP web services, another is RESTful web services. You can check out here, beside SOAP web services I have given web services, and beside the RESTful web services I have given web API. Means what? That one earlier there is only one services were there, web services. So earlier the SOAP services was called as a web services only. Now also if we indirectly if we say web service, it is nothing but a SOAP services only. If we say a API, that is comes to a RESTful services. Okay, so the SOAP services is the earlier one technology before the RESTful services. So there are some drawbacks that SOAP services have. Okay, we'll come to know, we'll study that also, what are the drawbacks. Okay, and because of that reason a RESTful services came. Okay, got it this point? What is uh, Okay, what is that mainly two types of web services? One is SOAP web services and RESTful web services. In future also, in this presentation, if I call web services, is nothing but a SOAP only. If I say API, then it is a RESTful services. Okay, now we'll discuss about web services. It's nothing but a SOAP. Okay, there are two major components in the SOAP services. One is SOAP. Okay, one is nothing but the SOAP is nothing but the actual service, and WSDL file, WSDL, we shortly call it as a WSDL file, WSDL also, web service description language, means nothing but it will give us the complete description of a web services. Okay, I will show how the WSDL will look. Okay, yes. Yeah, in this one you can check out, it is in a form of XML only, but it will give some what is the location, what is the server name, and finally it will also give you the format of the XML. okay, so what is the services are there, input file and output file, this kind of functionality it will give. WSDL is nothing but a web service description language, means what is the actual functionality of web services is there, it will give you. Okay, so SOAP is a acronym file, simple object access protocol. And one more thing here, what we have discussed, it is a protocol. Because of this reason, SOAP make itself heavy. Okay, SOAP is a protocol, so there will be lots of conditions will be there, constraints will be there while creating or communicating between SOAP. Okay, that is the main drawback of SOAP, is nothing but it is a protocol. SOAP is the acronym for simple object access. We are going to access some information as in a form of object, and it is a protocol. SOAP is a XML based protocol. And another one drawback of SOAP is that one, mainly we can only use XML only. Within XML we can use image, PDF, anything for exchange of information, but only the format of information what we are exchange, it is in XML base only. SOAP is a WTC recommendation for communication between application. SOAP is a XML base, so it is a platform independent and language independent. In other words, we know that one, whichever the programming communication if you are doing in XML, it is a platform and programming language independent. And WSDL is nothing but WSDL means WSDL, web service description language. WSDL is a XML document containing information about the web services, such as a method name, method parameter, and how to access it. WSDL is a part of UDDI. It is act as a interface between web service and application. WSDL pronounce as a WSDL. Okay, means WSDL. Okay, this we pronounce as a WSDL. Okay, so this is one example of WSDL, where it is also giving the service instance, and where is the location of the site, and whatever the web services will be there, it is extension as a ASMX. okay, in ASP.NET. Okay, so web service, SOAP services, SOAP stand for this also we have some, what is the advantages of SOAP we'll check out. Okay, SOAP defines its own security known as a WS security, language and long platform independent. Okay, these two are the advantages of the SOAP. There are disadvantages of SOAP which make it is a heavy, okay, slow, SOAP uses XML format that must be passed to a read, and it defines many standards, okay, that must be followed while developing SOAP application. So it is a slow and consumes more bandwidth and resources. Means what? It is a slow while we are developing and while we are making a security as well. And another one where it is make a slow in over internet, means as it is have heavy security and some other constraints also, standards also, so it will make use of more bandwidth, means it will make use of more internet. And WSDL dependent, okay, what is the WSDL? Okay, I have created one web services, I want to give this web services to one person, right? So I have to generate one WSDL document and I have to share with my client. So client uses the WSDL document and it will uses the services. Okay, so WSDL dependent. SOAP uses WSDL and does not have any other mechanism to discover the services. So we should have a WSDL document. Without WSDL, the client cannot use the services. Okay, this is the drawback of SOAP. Now we will come for API. Now after that SOAP, right, having seen some drawback of SOAP, only 5 minutes are there, so we will quickly finish this one and you guys have to rejoin once again. Okay, API. Now SOAP has drawback that slowness we cannot manage. Okay, we can manage for other requirements. Okay, but while we are coming to a company side or any standard professional, we should not afford slowness. So to overcome that the drawbacks, we are going to use API. API is not a protocol, it's just an architecture. Okay, it gives some way of communication, that's it. Okay, so RESTful web services, REST stand for representational state transfer. Okay, and REST is a architectural style, it is not a protocol. So earlier what we have discussed, web service, that is a complete protocol and it will use a standards. Okay, but in a REST it is just a architecture, so any language can define a functionality for the architecture and can use the REST services. Advantages of REST services. REST services are fast because there is no strict specification like SOAP. It consumes very less bandwidth and resources. Language and platform independent. This also language and platform independent. How it is language and platform independent is nothing but it is using a it is used communication for XML, JSON and any other types also it can use. Okay, it's not like only XML we have to go, we can go for JSON also. So as a SOAP, okay, API is a new extension for SOAP, we can say, means it is an extended version for SOAP. The same way the JSON is a extended version for API. okay, it's somewhat illogically I'm telling. Okay, when we comes, it has some other features also. Permit different data formats. REST web services permit different data formats such as plain text, HTML, XML and JSON. Now mostly use is JSON and XML. Okay, now we'll check out some differences between SOAP and REST API. SOAP is a protocol, REST is the architectural stack that we have already discussed. SOAP stand for this one, simple object access protocol, and REST stand for representation state transfer. SOAP cannot use REST, okay, because SOAP is the earlier technology and it doesn't have any knowledge about REST. But REST is just an architecture and it can use the SOAP as well as HTTP, but mostly we are going to use HTTP, okay, because HTTP is better and more efficient. SOAP uses services interface to expose the business logic. REST uses UI to expose business logic. Java, this is Java WS is the library package which provide a API for SOAP services. JAX RX is a Java API that provide a functionality for RESTful web services. SOAP defines standards to be strictly followed. REST does not define too much standards like SOAP. Okay, SOAP requires more bandwidth. REST does not require more bandwidth. SOAP defined its own security. REST's web services inherit security measures from the underlying transport. It's nothing but the admin and the developer has to define the security. Because of that reason, now we are going to work with certificate and lots of functionality we are going to work in this. Okay, SOAP permits XML data format only, but REST permit different data format, plain text, HTML, XML, JSON, etc. SOAP is less preferred than REST. REST is most preferred than SOAP. So we got an information that one, we have to learn both the things, SOAP as well as REST. Okay, but when we comes to industry, right, industry nowadays is using REST only. Okay, service oriented architecture is nothing but the actual how the architecture is there for the web services. Okay, there is only 1 minute remaining. Okay guys, please stay, it will be disconnected and again connected. Okay, I will continue my topic, and when it is disconnected you guys rejoin. Okay, service oriented architecture, SOA, we call it as a SOA. You can check out, there are two server in this image. One is message consumer, one server is message consumer, another is message provider. This is the where the web services are created, and this is the place where the web services are going to be consumed. For consuming, we have to make a request for the provider, and provider will process our request and provide the information. The information will be just an information exchange. Okay, services, in this one there are some technical terms are there. Services are logical entities defined by one or more published interface, nothing but web services. Service provider, okay, service oriented architecture, SOA, services are nothing but our logical programs. Okay, our indirectly I can say, illogically I can say that one, it's our program only, our services. Provider, service provider is nothing but the person who is providing the services. Example, Amazon. AWS is providing by the Amazon. Service consumer is nothing but the DHL. Okay, DHL using warehouse service management system from the Amazon, like that. Okay, it can be the consumer, it can be called as a requester or the client that call a service provider. A service consumer can another service or an end user application. Okay, so the consumer also a service, okay, or a end user application. A end user application can be a Windows application, can be a web application. Mostly 98% it will be a web application only. Okay, service locator, that is nothing but the URL. Okay, it is a service provider, it is a service provider that act as a registry. It is responsible for examining service provider interface and provide locations, service location. Service broker, it is a service provider that pass service request to one more additional service providers. Okay, example, DHL is using Amazon Web Services, and whenever Amazon give any order to the DHL take that information, and again DHL also communicate with Blue Dot for shipping. Okay, DHL is just a warehouse company, Amazon is a online platform. Warehouse company will keep the stocks, Amazon make an interface with the user. Whenever user place order, Amazon says to the DHL that one, this order received, please process this order. So DHL need to ship the order to the customer. But what DHL will do, DHL only keep the stock, but it will again communicate with the Blue Dot will make a somewhat interfaces, already has provided services. So Blue Dot will do the delivery, it will come to DHL point, pick the order and go to the customer who has order and give that order. That's it. Like this, another extra brokerage. So there are two types of library. Okay, JavaX, okay, JAXWS, which is used for window web services, JAX RX for RESTful services. Now we have to check for some programs. Okay, I have created a RESTful service program. Okay, and for this one, please remember you have to download these files. Okay, API I have created. Okay, if you are working with API, right, this jersey as well as JAX RX jar file you have to download. Okay, that link I will provide to you. Download that jar file and put in the library, so whenever it will be our server will started, it will go, it will get these locations and it will make our classes as a services. Okay, this is libraries we have imported, and we will come to our, now you can check out, I am coming to Java resources. Nothing but the Java resources will contain only Java classes. Now I have created one test one package. Under the package I am creating my home class. Earlier I have told that one, what is web services, is there is nothing else, our one program, that's it, our one program. In this one we will create some methods. These methods, each and every method will act as a one service. Okay, now you can check out here, I am saying that one path for to access this application, they have to link for this path, and it is a class containing two methods. Okay, these two methods I have annotated with these two annotation. Annotation will give you one extra information we have already discussed, right? Annotation is the extra information about the method, class or a variable. So in this one, this get annotation, what it is telling, this method what I have created, right, welcome home, this is a method, it will act as a HTTP get method. Okay, sorry for disturbance, some messages were there, I was gone to see that one. So get annotation defines that one, whatever the next upcoming method is there, it is a HTTP get method. So this method is a get service, get web API. Okay, if I want a post, I can make at post. You can check out, now this is become a post API. Okay, so in this one what I am saying, produces means what type of data it is producing. It will produce a like XML string. Okay, it will produce a XML string. Now what this post will produce us, it will produce us a media type as a JSON application. Okay, means some object we are returning that is a in a format of JSON. Okay, if you guys do more practical on this one, you will learn a good APIs. Okay, and another one more things, if you learn this API concept, right, this is a very basic API we have created, and at the beginning itself I have shown one API we have consumed. If you learn both things, how to create API of your own and how to consume others API, other provider API, it could be Amazon, it could be Google Cloud, it would be anything else, right? If you learn these two things, now itself you will get a good software engineering developer job. With this, only few things you have to be learn, example CSS, JavaScript, and how to develop a web application, that's it. We have already discussed how to develop a web application using Servlet JSP, and two extra things what you have to learn, CSS and JavaScript, how to use, where to use, and what is the important of those things. These are the combined one package is there. If you guys do really little work and just prepare a resume using this information, now itself you will get a call for interview. Okay, so please do good practical in this one. Okay, so in this one we have created, you can check out one simple API is there, post API. Okay, it's provided as a JSON information, and this is you can check out one string I'm just returning, and it is in JSON format, right? So this one you should have for creating any API, you should have to work with this jar file. You should have to download this jar file, and after downloading this jar file, example, these other things one by one as you will use this guide, these things are going to be imported automatically from this jar file. Okay, this is one simple things. Okay, now another thing what we have to discuss is web services, how we can create a web services in Java. Okay, so we'll continue that topics tomorrow, because around almost 1 hour it is happened to join this class, right? If you guys have any doubt, you can ask me related to web services theory, and one web services we have consumed from the open weather. If you have any question on that one, you can ask. If in creating any web API, if you have any doubt, you can ask me right now. And once again, I will try to show you that API which we have created. Okay, it is a dynamic web application. There is no extra thing I have done. Okay, in this one, some these libraries I have downloaded. If I want to communicate to any API, and I need this API for working with JSON information, I need this API jar file, and this is for log the server, for logging information server, and this is one JSP I have created, and one servlet I have created. In the servlet I am going to call the API. Okay, this is one getter setter method. In this one it has only properties, so using this property we can store information in our Java. Okay, now I am going to run this one, just start run as a server, save and run. Yesterday some server getting some error, because of that reason it was not able to run, and I not able to show you this one, but today I have sat and I have resolved those errors. Okay, now server is still running. The server got started, you can check out. Okay, instead of this one we will go for our extra browser, this one. Okay, you can check out localhost from my application, it is coming, and right now I will select Kolkata. Okay, if I select Kolkata, it is communicating to the server, and again it is showing to the, you can check out city name is Kolkata, temperature is 32, maximum temperature means it is reaches to maximum, minimum it is, everything is same, and pressure is 1700, and humidity 70% humidity is there. Humidity is nothing but what is the air quality. Okay, 70% something is polluted. Okay, something water or something has been there. Okay, pressure and temperature is this one, maximum temperature is 24, Bangalore maximum temperature is 24, but it is 33 only. This is one simple application, even though I have shared that link, but I will request you guys go through online tutorials. Okay, go through some other sources also, try to consume your other APIs, web services like WhatsApp APIs, create, develop some dynamic web application consuming that APIs, do the things. If you won't get anything, you can communicate with me, so I can help you. Okay, thank you all. Shall we end up now?
Okay, sir.
Yeah, thank you.